Dalet was the patron of Acholi football team and passionate about football in the whole of northern Uganda. He supported the Acholi province greatly with resources and offered them a bus plus distributing balls to the teams in the region. The sorrowful sister-in-law of the deceased Irene Imono says that Jacob loved sport so much, and during his campaigns, he used to distribute balls to his constituent. His works is remembered dearly by the Acholi people.
Motorbike, and he's going to check home. Three hours is there. Even sometimes he drives back to Parliament. You remember? Last time he has been there in Parliament. Driving. So, that's been so good to people in Umoro. Actually, the whole region, when he's campaigning, campaign, and he saw it, what's come out last year through him, has been a good man. He loves the country, so I want this thing to continue.
I have moved around his home. I can assure you, Ugandans, that this gentleman was a real all-round sports lover. As you enter inside at the compound of his home, the first thing to welcome you at the gate as soon as you enter is the basketball court. Now, that one clearly tells you that he was a man who loved sports so much. We have so many politicians in this country, of course, and so many lawmakers in this country, but who do not love sports like level. But I opted to bring you through to come and check on his gym, where he used to do his gym sessions from. Now, in his gym session here, you have also, of course, the equipment for gym, but at the same time, you have a bicycle. The motorcycle is outside, it's not here. You even have an helmet. Remember, Jacob Olanya was a very good motor rider. Yes, there are other equipment here. These are basically for strength, and you can see some of these gadgets, the shoes. These are his shoes for riding. If you really can't see, he has all the gadgets. Then you also have the boxing gloves here, if I could really try to show you a little bit. Now, these are some of these boxing gloves. Never mind the color. I know some of you have got it too. So, these are his boxing gloves. Now, why are we showing you all this? For us in the sports fraternity, we are going to miss a very, very big sports lover in this nation. He loved sports to the fact that, to the level that every sport he almost did. One, he was the patron of Acholi Province football team. He actually contributed to the success of Acholi football team that they even won. And then after that, he prayed to give them a bus. And then from the reliable information I got from last year, he delivered the bus to the team, and the team has the bus. And it is the only province of football in the whole of Uganda that has a football team, I mean a bus. Now, when you leave that aside, putting the bicycling and the motor riding. Now, let's come to boxing. Yeah, I showed you the gloves. Now, this is where he used to train from. Plus, some of his colleagues and some of the friends, some of the young people he used to train with. He didn't used to train alone here. Now, people like the Shadi Musas, people like Semuju can tell you, people like Okero from North can tell you about boxing.
Jacob did not only stop at giving out money and balls to the teams, he went further to put in place a gym facility together with a boxing training facility at his home. The Vice President, Road Safety and Vintage, FMEO, Ray Chivita, reveals that the late Jacob Olanya played a pivot role in enacting the East African Community Customs Management Act that saw motorbikes receive tax exemptions.
2015, I was the General Secretary. Mr. Dusman Oke was now the RDC, was the Vice President. At that time, Jacob Olanya had just become the deputy speaker, and we invited him for an enduro event because we found out that he actually owned an enduro bike. So we invited him to Simbe Estates, where he participated, and then we presented this case. we were very surprised that Jacob picked it up very quickly. And for me, the Parliament of Uganda and Uganda at large has lost a mover, because Jacob picked up this very quickly when we introduced it to him.
With a tax exemption on imported motorbikes, this has since paved way for Motorsport Family to import latest bikes, which helped Team Uganda finish third overall in the FIM Motocross of Africa Championships in Zimbabwe in 2019.
Most of our riders, and that is the year we took most riders to Zimbabwe, 2018, most of our riders had new bikes. And I remember the Zimbabwe Federation awarding Uganda as the most improved country in terms of participation, because we took about 30 riders, which was the first of its kind. We had never taken so many riders to South Africa, those South African countries. And sometimes, for those who have been around, you remember the days of Ahmed Tamale, who took a bike in parts, unbundled it. It was an old bike, and he was a lone representative for Uganda, unbundled the bike. Then when we reached there, he was asking for spares from other teams. And Uganda had been known for a country that disturbs other countries for asking for high-end bikes. This time we took over 30 riders, and all our riders had new bikes, and those bikes were in good condition to participate. So actually that was 2019, 1 year after the enactment of the law. That was 2019. And after that event, the Motocross of African Nations, Uganda came back as the third country on the African continent.
A member of the Uganda Bikers Association, Jacob Olanya, did not only support the sport, but also took part in the FMU Enduro Championship in 2015 and 16.
Jacob Olanya took part in about two Enduro events. Enduro events in Nsimbe Estates. Enduro is an endurance discipline in the sport of motorcycling. It is like you see the country rallies, the cross-country rallies, which we do in motor rally. Now, this side is on the bike side. And we used to do a lot of them in the Nsimbe Estates, Fiduga Flowers, on Masaka Road. So he took part in about two events, but he was a permanent guest in many of our motorcycling activities. He also took part in quite a number of the Uganda Bikers Association's activities as a member. He was a registered member, and Uganda Bikers Association is also a member of FMU. So Jacob Olanya was part and parcel of motorsports.
With all his love and support towards the growth of the sport, he has left the federation divided, with some riders under FMU, while others under the roof of MAU that is spearheaded by Barack Holland. Report compiled by Simon Semazi and Sharon Adong for the news.